Hello, YouTube! Kagemaro here, back in Back to the Future. Back to some familiar stuff, and, I kinda have some idea what I need to be doing. I accidentally saw some stuff while I was thumbnailing the last video. Let's get into it. Shouldn't take more than an hour to finish this.
Locked. She missed a spot.
Okay. Wrong button.
This is my axe. There are many like it, but this one is mine.
Okay, you say so.
That's no way to treat such a fine guitar. That leads to the soup, Mo. Leech is in there.
Yeah, you said.
That's no way.
Okay, so not exactly. So, what I need to do here? Plank must mean something, right?
I don't want to go digging through the trash unless I...
Okay, let's go back and see about that. See if we can find Lorraine's Abuzi. Well, that's Lorraine.
Mom? Mom, look, I'm on your side. If you've got a problem, I want to help, but this is a choice you gotta make yourself.
Oh, look at you. You're such a sweet boy. I'm so glad you take after me rather than your father.
Yeah. Lorraine, what?
Ugh, I can't live like this.
Dad, you're not helping.
Oh, but I disagree, Martin. It's important that I catch her in the act so I can get it on tape. Once it's on tape, I can show her that she has a problem.
That's ridiculous, Dad. You're acting like this is some kind of sting operation.
Huh? Where'd she go?
Mom?
Aha! I knew it! There! What did you just hide? That was some sort of fruity liqueur!
It's a spray bottle of Simple Orange for the cleaning I'm trying to do!
Lorraine, I'm sorry. It's just that you're acting so cagey lately.
Cagey? Maybe I'm acting like I don't want to be spied on all the time.
It's not all the time.
What's the problem, citizen?
Yeah, I'll have a double-double animal style with fries and a diet.
That's it. It's called an emergency intercom for a reason. I'm wrapping you for an SCR 300. Take your demerit printout before you go.
I don't want to annoy whoever's on the other end of that thing.
Did I get a demerit printout? No. I don't know. Okay. So how do
Mom?
I get the...
So, what's up with Dad?
Ugh, indeed. What is up with him?
That setup in his garage is pretty intense.
That's not the word I'd use. More like creepy.
I heard that.
Yeah. God, you did. You're listening to everyone. Because you're creepy.
What about you, Mom?
What about me?
What are you doing out here polishing the statue?
I know. I was scheduled to clean the clock this month, but then Needle's mom ate some of that bad tofu that's been going around. So there was some reshuffling in the L Sector duty roster, and here I am. I kinda wish I was cleaning the clock, though. So much nicer up there without all the cameras.
The cameras?
Wave to Big Brother! Or Big Husband in this case.
I saw you talking to Biff about the Citizen Plus program.
Biff says I'd be a perfect candidate for it.
I know Biff, and if that's what the Citizen Plus program does to people, then you don't want any part of it.
But Biff has been reformed. Look at him. He seems so happy now. So at peace with this town. What I wouldn't give.
He's a total veg, Mom.
Your father is always telling me that I don't invest enough in the workings of our great Citizen Brown. Maybe it's time for me to turn a new leaf and just go with the flow.
Okay, just hold off for a bit, please. I don't want you doing anything rash. All right, let's talk about something else.
Alrighty, dear.
I'm having a bad day, Mom. Can I ask you a few things?
We all have our share, son.
I lost my timesheet. What have I got going on this week?
Well, Monday is Junior Brown Brigade.
Junior what now?
And Tuesday is Lord. Model UN.
Model Lord. UN?
Mm-hmm. You represent Djibouti. On Wednesday, you'll be overseeing the board game club at the rec
center. Okay, I've heard enough. I saw Jennifer earlier today.
Oh, Jennifer. What a spunky gal. Are you two patching things up?
She totally blew me off.
Well, I'm not the world's biggest dating expert, seeing as how I married the first guy to fall from the sky. But maybe you should spend a little less time with your microscopes and ant farms, and a little more time tending to her needs. What kind of things is she passionate about, Martin? What are her interests?
I don't even know anymore.
You see?
Everyone is treating me like some sort of goody-two-shoes, Mom.
They're just jealous that you're such a perfect citizen of Hill Valley.
Have I always been this way?
Always been a perfect little son? Going on 18 years now.
What about that time I set fire to the living room?
Oh, but you only did that so you could show us the fire retardant you made with your chemistry set.
Heavy. All right, let's...
Alrighty, D.
Yeah. Ask about the flask again. I don't know. It's gonna be getting.
Mom, please.
Yeah, Lorraine. Listen to us.
Oh,
damn it, Dad.
What?
Butt out. Mom? Mom?
Huh? Where'd she go?
Mom?
Aha! I knew it. Hey, is that?
No.
Lorraine, don't ignore me.
Mom? I feel like I don't know anybody anymore.
Well, Martin, that could be a sign you need to get out more.
Jen's dad doesn't seem to like me very much.
He's just a little stressed out, dear. Filling the crime-stomping shoes of his legendary father makes poor Danny Jr. a little twitchy.
So I see.
But he gets the job done. Between him and his father, Hill Valley's been as dry as the Sahara Desert for decades now. Unfortunately.
Dry. Doc was right. We did overdo it. Ugh.
Being so perfect must take a...
Is it just me or does Hill Valley feel really strict today?
Some might even call it stifling. But you didn't hear that from me.
Biff told me that he got in trouble for public displays of affection.
Can you believe it? Sure, things got a little out of control back in the 60s with the free love and all, but now even holding hands will get you a verbal warning.
Wait, so you can't even kiss?
Can't even hug. It's barbaric. City Hall treats us like a bunch of children going to the movies.
Biff was talking about all the contraband he used to keep. Do you know anything about that?
What are you implying, Martin?
I'm not implying anything. I just want to know what kind of contraband might still be around, you know, so I could watch out for it, like a good citizen.
Well, I wouldn't know about such things, but people still smuggle alcohol in from the next county. I heard the kids at school have been smuggling Xerox copies of Dungeons and Dragons. I bet you'd be into something like that, huh?
I'll get back to you on that.
The Dungeons and Dragons is illegal.
Is it true that Biff was responsible for getting dogs outlawed?
I think that was all Edna's idea. She's always had a sore spot for dogs. Now, your father and I, we love dogs.
You do? I didn't know that. How come we never had a dog?
We had meant to get one to teach you children about responsibility, but by the time we had you, dogs had already been banned. Now I don't think we'll ever have the chance to raise a puppy.
Jeez, Mom, that could be the saddest thing I've ever heard. All right, let's talk about some...
Alrighty.
Mom, please.
Yeah, Lorraine, listen to us.
Ugh!
Damn it, Dad!
What?
Butt out!
Huh?
Mom?
Hey!
No! George!
Sorry, just pretend I'm not here.
How can I do that when I can hear you looming over me?
I'm not looming. I'm looking out for you.
I can't. Yeah, that is so. Then move on to something else.
Okay. Welcome to Soup Mo, where soup is just... Oh, it's you. This better be important, McFly.
Leech, was that Jennifer?
Well, A, it's none of your business. And B, seeing as she ain't your chick no more, yeah.
Okay, now this timeline is really pissing me off. You got a cold or something?
Ugh, it's allergies. I swear, there's a dog hanging out around here somewhere.
A dog?
Yeah, and the stupid mutt keeps trying to steal my free samples.
You and Jennifer? Really?
Oh, is the poor little nerd jealous?
Well, yeah, and a little disgusted.
That's probably the soup.
Where are the free samples?
Here. I keep them behind the counter.
Oh, God.
If you puke, you're cleaning it up, wuss.
I can't finish this.
Not my problem.
Why are the samples behind the counter?
I can't leave them out, dude. There's a DOG running around town, and he keeps going after the sample tray, knocking them all over the ground.
A dog? Wait, these samples haven't been on the ground, have they?
Jeez, McFly, relax. They're fresh. Mostly.
Mostly.
What are those things?
Those are the liver and peas with soy cheese hot dogs.
Ew.
You and me both, brown noser.
About this dog, what's he look like?
Beats me. He's a smart little SOB. He only comes around when my back is turned.
Then how do you know it's a dog? You can smell him?
Allergies, dimwit.
What's on the menu?
Soup.
Just soup?
And more.
What falls under the more category?
We got neat loaf. It's made with textured wheat protein.
No thanks.
Yeah.
What kind of soup you got?
Scrolle...
Ribellini?
Yeah, that's right.
Some things never change.
That's it? What?
What else falls under the more category?
Well, there's the humburger. It's made from pressed roasted hummus.
Do you have any real meat back there?
Define real.
I'm afraid to ask, but what other non-soup food do you have? Anything edible?
Well, we have these pea edible. And liver eatable. With soy cheese hot dogs. They're new, and we're offering free samples. You want one?
You better treat Jen with respect, Leech.
Hey, I got nothing but respect for Jennifer. Respect for her eyes, for her hips, the way she wriggles when she...
Hey!
Now, that dork that let her get away... There's a loser that I got no respect for.
You sure there's
not
a dog around
this guy.
Here?
Listen, smart boy. There's only two things I'm allergic to. Dogs and disco, and I don't hear no chick-a-bow-wow, do you?
No.
Then it's a dog.
See ya.
Smell you later.
Hey, Hey! There's that mangy! Go get him, McFly!
Is that Einstein?
Peas, liver, and soy. Three things that have nothing to do with hot dogs. Reminds me of the liver treats Doc used to give Einstein.
Let's see if I can get her some music here. There we go.
Check this out.
What? You swiped your big brother's guitar? Is that supposed to impress me?
It's not my brother's, it's mine.
Yeah, sure. And you'd play it for me, only you don't have an amp.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Pathetic.
Okay, need an amp.
He's gotta be hiding in here somewhere. You in there, Einie? Or whatever your name is these days? Not a sign of him.
Oh, he got away. Okay. I'll need to do this proper.
My spray can?
Oh. Huh.
Dork.
There he goes, okay. Okay, let's go back and find 90.
Where could he be hiding? Decency prevents me from leaving this here. I bet you're under here. Not a sign of him. Spray paint. Directions say to apply a thin coat and let dry. Avoid touching or tracking wet paint.
Tracking?
Pinheads, huh? Figures. Give me that.
She missed a spot.
Okay, so it's not the most artful. This puzzle might take a little bit to figure out. But I got time.
Where could he be hiding? Stay put now, boy, wherever you are. Not a sign of him. I don't want to go dig.
Okay, so I can't go back there till Lyman's there. I don't think more to the spray can. I love that angle, though. Camera angle there. That's very tight.
What to paint? That leads to the...
has a bit of a weirdness.
Don't even think about it. Don't do it again.
Sorry. Unless he doesn't like the pinheads. So long, I have to keep going back here for 3 seconds.
Where could he be hiding? Decency prevents me from leaving this here. Decency prevents me from leaving this here. Stay put now, boy, wherever you are.
Okay, so maybe I have to.
Decency. Decency prevent. Giving this to any person would. Decency prevents.
Might have to go.
Where could he be hiding?
Oh, that's what I need to do. Okay. So I said that there. Okay.
You in there, Einie? Or whatever your name is these days?
That's why I was talking about tracking, okay. I got it.
It would look better blue.
Eventually with nice tag there, so that's plus.
Now we're in business.
Okay, so now do I need the hideous hot dog sample?
Decency prevent. outsmarted you, didn't I? Oh, don't be like that, Einie. Look, Einie, I've got a treat for you. Attaboy, now hold still. See, I'm not such a bad guy, right? Whoa, okay. I guess I've won you over. I wish they were all this easy. Huh? What is it, boy? Einstein, okay. Wait! No! Help!
Invasion of the body center is up there.
Rabies, help!
Back! Down! Sit! Play dead!
Officer Parker, subdue that beast at once!
Einstein, sit!
Einstein? Oh, if he bites me, you'll be in a world of trouble, citizen! Wait, I know that creature. Officer Parker, that's the stray that keeps escaping the kennel. I thought he was muzzled.
I took the muzzle off.
You what?
That's right, he's my dog now.
Citizen, you are in violation of Statute 357K.
Parker, demerit this hooligan at once. I'll return this creature to the kennel.
Yes, ma'am.
Filthy, wretched beasts.
Don't worry, Einie. Once I fix all this, you'll be back with Doc and romping through time.
Now stay out of trouble, unless you want a visit from Citizen Brown.
Okay, it's a start.
This one's for harboring or owning a vicious dog. Aw, Einstein's just misunderstood. A stranger in a strange land. Like me.
Made that joke last episode, aren't he? I want to do that, blah.
It's got my name on it. They couldn't do anything with this.
Okay, but Jen might be interested. I also need to find an amp.
What is it now?
You and Leech, Jennifer?
Hey, don't badmouth Leech. There's a lot more to him than soup, you know.
Like what?
For one thing, he wields an axe like nobody's business.
So you got yourself a new guitar player.
What can I say? I'm a girl who appreciates a hot lick.
Yeah, I remember. Come on, Jennifer. Nobody in town plays guitar like me.
I'm talking electric guitar, Martin. I'm gonna be honest, the ukulele has to go.
I can outplay your loser boyfriend any day of the week.
You're that desperate to get to first base.
Did you say first or fourth?
I'd give you 2.5. But first you gotta prove you've got better fingers than Leech. You ready to throw down?
I was born ready.
You got a guitar?
Never leave home without it.
Hold on.
Okay, let's see.
You can knock on my door anytime.
Hold it, we got company.
McFly, what's that was doing here?
He says he can outplay you. I told him, there's no one in Hill Valley better than you. You want to go prove it?
The Ring of Rock?
The Ring of Rock.
Don't crush him too bad. Just teach him a lesson.
Okay,
look fly. That was totally awesome.
You know
what
it.
Can I say? Some guys got it and some guys don't.
You broke my head, Doc.
I think I've got a new idol. Come here.
Wait, I got a better idea. What was it you called me? A square?
A girl's entitled to make a mistake, isn't she? Oh. Oh. Hooliganism! Delinquency! Officer Parker! I just caught these two degenerates violating statute number...
Jennifer!
Daddy! 476D!
Open mouths?
And tongues!
You've gone too far, Jennifer.
What's the big deal? It's only hormones.
Stop! We don't use words like that in this town.
Seriously? I'll deal with you later, young lady. We're gonna have to have a long talk
health class.
About the Citizen Plus program.
What?
Oh, come on.
Officer, give Mr. McFly a 476D's worth of demerits. I'll tend to your wayward
yes,
daughter.
Yes, ma'am. And this is for getting my daughter in trouble with Citizen Edna. Now keep out of trouble, or Citizen Brown
you
will come down
him?
On you like a brick wall.
You poked him? What the... Okay, did that. I still need more. Might have to go home for that. It said start with learning secret stash. Very well, the last one I get, so. I got my belt. Top clip. Here, okay.
Another day in Hill Valley.
Dad? Yo, Dad!
Huh? Oh, hello, son. What's on your mind?
Okay, Dad, we need to talk. Hill Valley has a lot of rules.
It certainly does, for our...
Actually, I got a confession. I got caught with Jennifer... We were being affectionate.
I'm shocked, Martin.
And I got some demerits.
As well you should. This type of behavior is unworthy of a Hill Valley boy. I don't know where you possibly learned it. Certainly not from your mother and me.
Certainly not.
Did you ever harbor a dangerous animal?
Ha ha!
Okay.
Yeah?
Well, I'll...
Supervise.
I'll leave you to...
Right.
Hey, demerit. Hey, what for? Insufficient.
Oh, it's recording. I don't want to...
I could want to.
Good morning, Mrs. Brown. Please address me as Mrs. Citizen...
time for game.
Hey, demerit.
W-O-P-R. Mom? Mom, please.
What?
What? Mom? Mom?
Hey!
No!
Lorraine!
No! No!
Lorraine, I'm just trying to look out for you. You know the kind of trouble we can get into if you're drinking again.
George! I wouldn't be so on edge if you weren't suffocating me all the time.
Was that an admission?
Hey, got a sec, Biff?
Sure, Martin. What's on your mind?
How did they leave?
I can get used to this.
Please, Martin. Don't make me angry.
All right, Biff. You're off the hook this time. So, about...
Gosh, Martin. And plus...
Ellen?
Thank
you. See you.
Bye, Martin!
It's recorded. I'm not sure Dad would approve of me getting...
Shadow. Not exactly. Sorry, but I don't know. I should have thought of that. Me dum-dum sometime.
Citizen. Mom?
What?
Mom?
Lorraine, I'm sorry. It's just... What happened? What the heck am I looking at?
Yes.
There she is. Okay. Hey, Ma!
Mom, now that Dad isn't watching.
Oh, Martin.
Was that a flask, Mom?
Flask? Don't be ridiculous. I...
Look, it's okay, Mom. Get a hold of yourself.
Oh, your father's right. I'm backsliding. But it's been so hard, what with your brother and sister leaving, and then your father getting obsessed with his monitors, and...
Let me take care of the flask. Dad doesn't have to know anything about it.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart. I couldn't bear the thought of facing your father over this.
This timeline sucks. Mom and Dad are fighting again. Mom's drinking. It's like everything Doc and I ever did to fix things is falling apart. Time to get some attention.
Okay, now how to make the best use of this?
Ah, there's gotta be a better person to sh-
Officer Parker, I'm guessing?
Hands up, citizen. Assume the position.
Here goes nothing.
There better be apple juice in this.
Why don't you open it and find out?
Don't get smart with me.
You can't help it. He's a very smart boy.
I knew you were no good, McFly.
Officer Parker, what seems to be the problem here?
Citizen McFly, ma'am. Came strolling up with a 181B violation in his pocket.
Ugh. You, young citizen, where did you get that... booze?
Nowhere.
Is he being smart with me?
Yeah, he played that attitude on me as well.
Can we just fast forward the lecture and just get this over with already?
No! Officer,
stop
demerit
with the pushing
him
and poking.
Severely. And as for the alcohol, drop it into the recycling bin.
With pleasure, ma'am. Now, keep your nose clean, or you'll find yourself in front of Citizen Brown.
McFly!
Hey, Jennifer. Are you still angry with me?
Angry? Nah. The threat of being Citizen Plus was worth it just to see my dad's veins go all purple like that.
Great, because I gotta go.
Jeez, Martin, what's gotten into you? Booze, dogs, necking in public? It's like you're a different guy today. A way cooler guy.
I know this is gonna be hard to believe, but I'm the same guy I've always been. It's everyone else who's messed up. And stop calling me Martin. It's Marty.
Well, Marty, what's next on the agenda? Knocking over banks?
Maybe. What's a guy gotta do to get in trouble around here?
I think you're about to find out.
You, citizen!
Get out of here, Jen.
Not a problem.
Are you Martin Seamus McFly?
Yes. Seamus.
We have a warrant for your detention.
Detention?
You've accrued over 15,000 demerits in the past 24 hours.
Strickland's cool. Gonna be there?
Is it, young Mr. McFly? Is being branded as a criminal of weak moral character cool?
In this instance,
weak, but
yeah.
You are in a heap of trouble.
Trouble?
Oh my, yes. But don't worry, we're here to take care of you.
Like your Citizen Plus program took care of Biff?
Perhaps. The program is in need of new volunteers. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. First, let's see what Citizen Brown has to say about your particular strain of antisocial behavior.
You're taking me to Citizen Brown?
Immediately. Officers, away with him.
Yes,
ma'am.
It's about time.
Yeah.
I always knew your goody two-shoes A-plus student act was too good to be true.
It looks like the clock hands there. Oh, nice big door. Really?
Come in, citizen.
Office is right behind the clock there of all the kids going
Martin
on.
Martin McFly, age 18, that's resident of Sector L.
I figured
Father that. George, Mother Lorraine, president of the Junior Brown Brigade. Recipient of a full ride scholarship to Strickland College. Winner of the Courthouse Challenge Deportment Award. Zero demerits until this morning. The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is... what happened to you?
Jesus Christ, Doc, what happened to you?
Doc, interesting. You regard me as a doctor, indicating awareness that you're suffering from some variety of mental disorder. That's a hopeful sign, Martin. Of course, I'm not actually a doctor, but I do have the tools to turn you around and put you back on the road to societal normalization. Shall we begin with a few questions to establish a baseline?
Forget questions. You're the one who needs to turn around.
Explain.
This whole crazy world you've created, it's totally mental. There's all these stupid rules and everybody's acting all weird. My dad's turned into this creepy snoop. Mom's completely pathetic. And Jennifer's kind of scary. And Biff, it's like he's a zombie or something. And it's all basically your fault.
So you believe this interview is really more about me than you?
Yes.
You went through all this trouble just to deliver a message to me in person?
Yes.
A cry for help, as it were.
Yes! No, wait.
Tell me, Martin. Is your mother on the sauce again?
Forget my mother. She's not the issue here.
Don't ever forget your mother, Martin. Your parents are your superiors, and respect for one's superiors is absolutely essential to the Hill Valley Order. I'm surprised your father hasn't set you straight on this point. He's shown himself to be a very obedient and cooperative citizen.
You mean a warped citizen? He's supposed to be a science fiction writer, not a peeping Tom. And you're supposed to invent a time machine.
Time machine?
Yeah, Doc, listen to me. You don't remember it, but you built a time machine out of a DeLorean.
Out of a DeLorean?
Why?
Well, just for the hell of it, I guess. Plus, the steel frame of the DeLorean, dispersal, I don't know. It was important for some reason.
Fascinating.
Yes, it is fascinating. It's amazing. It's incredible. But you don't know it because you've never invented it. You're not the real Doc Brown. You gotta believe me.
And this is because?
Everything got screwed up when I went back in time to 1931.
Sounds like this time machine is a very impractical and dangerous invention.
What chances should I go with here?
Yes, I mean, no. What I mean is it's messed up a lot of things, but first, it made a lot of things better. Like my mom and my dad. It was only thanks to your time machine that they ever became successful and happy.
So they're happy.
But they're not, because you summoned me back in time and somehow your timeline got messed up. And everybody else is along with it.
I see.
No, you don't. Think back. Don't you remember me? We knew each other when you were 18. I'm Michael Corleone.
Incredible. This case is more serious than I'd imagined. The boy has fabricated an alternate reality.
This is not working.
Believe me, I wish I had fabricated it.
Calm down, Martin. I'm not blaming you for anything. The failure is ours, not yours. Obviously, there was a drastic flaw in your social conditioning.
Yeah, you don't understand.
No, I don't understand yet, but I want to. I want to get at the root of your problem. Keep talking.
I don't know if these choices are making any difference.
Take your time. Look around the room. Perhaps something here will stimulate your memory.
I just noticed that thing there kind of looked like a flux capacitor.
So that's what Judge Brown looked like. I never actually saw him.
Of course not. He died before you were born. He was my biggest supporter.
Still haven't actually seen him.
That's a switch. Last time I saw your younger self, you and your dad had just had a big falling out over your decision to become an inventor instead of a lawyer. Isn't that right?
An impressively detailed illusion. Keep talking.
I can't tell if it's a guy celebrating a touchdown or chained up in a gulag. Glass half full, Marty. Half full. Okay, take a look at this picture of Einstein here.
The dog. Harboring dangerous animals is a municipal offense.
Yeah, they told me. But you harbored this very same animal once, a long time ago. Remember the test run of your rocket car? Einstein landed on the roof of the courthouse.
I do recall something of the sort, but naturally it couldn't have been the same dog.
Wasn't anything natural about it. Einstein's a time traveler too, thanks to your invention.
Bizarre fantasy life. Go on, proceed.
You still got the movie ticket.
Indeed I do. A memento of my first date with Edna. I took her to see The Virtuous Husband.
And you never saw Frankenstein. You were supposed to go see Frankenstein that night. It was going to give you the inspiration you needed to pull off your big demonstration at the Hill Valley Expo.
Inspired by Frankenstein? How whimsical, not to mention historically inaccurate. My darly wife is all the scientific muse I've ever needed. From my successful demonstration at the 31 Expo all the way up to my cutting-edge Citizen Plus program.
Successful? It was supposed to be a failure. Something about that clock looks familiar. Something about... Hey, this is your fish tank.
Yes, that is my fish tank.
It looks much better without all the bacteria.
What? Edna just had it cleaned.
Yeah, but in 1931 it was full of bacteria that we used to make rocket fuel. Remember?
Stop trying to confuse me! My whole life has been dedicated to the practical use of technology to shape a more efficient, orderly society. Ask anyone. It's a fact. You can look it up.
You know better, right? Emmett?
Wrong. Do you see this picture? I keep it close by me to remind me of the moment when my life's course became clear. August 25th, 1931. The day I single-handedly captured Kit Tannen, the scourge of Hill Valley.
Single-handedly?
And not incidentally the day I caught the eye of Edna Strickland, my scientific muse and the love of my life. Take a look. What you see there is a young man who understands his destiny.
That's not what I see.
What do you see?
Be? I think it is.
What?
It's me. And you. The other you.
It is me. And you. But how? Michael? It's impossible.
No. It's science. Your science, Doc.
In this other world, the one you say you come from, Am I happy there?
Very happy. You've got two great sons.
Sons?
Yes, and a fantastic wife.
Not Edna?
Not even remotely. And your invention. Jeez, Doc, you can go anywhere you want to. Anywhere in time. You're the luckiest guy in the universe.
And what about Hill Valley?
Hill Valley. You know it's got problems. A little bit of urban decay here, a little bit of crime there. It's a normal city. People are happy, mostly. And even when they're miserable, they're not miserable like they are in your Hill Valley.
Stop! There are no miserable people in my Hill Valley.
Give me a break. You don't really believe...
My citizens lead lives of order and peace. Nobody worries. Nobody complains.
Only because they're afraid to. Jeez, open your eyes, will you? You and Edna have got them all terrorized.
That's Mrs. Brown to you, sonny.
Doc.
Kindly address me as your honor. We worked for over 50 years, my wife and I. Every waking moment devoted to ridding Hill Valley of vice and disorder. And you dare to claim that our citizens are unhappy?
Yeah, I do. I've seen it. They're just too afraid to speak up.
Afraid? Afraid of what?
Afraid of the consequences of their actions, Doc. You run this place like it's a police state.
Nonsense.
I can prove it.
All right then, time travel boy. You do that. And until you do, I'm going to treat your wild story as just that. A story told by a madman. And I've determined that the best treatment is simply to let the insanity run its course.
So, is the interview over? Should I leave?
Please do. I'm very busy. I've got a city to run.
Fine, but I'll be back with proof.
Deed their father's take, Marty.
Doc wants proof that Hill Valley isn't the perfect place he thinks it is. One smoking gun coming up. Death!
Pop out the tape, son. I think it's done rewinding.
Whoa, take it easy. Sit here.
Guess I blacked out for a minute there. Fell out of my chair.
Fell nothing. Somebody whacked you.
Whacked me? Impossible. We take great pride in the fact that incidences of physical violence in Hill Valley have fallen to virtually...
Who did it? Can you tell me?
This can't be happening.
There's gotta be a clue around here somewhere.
The giant bat?
That's not one of our bats, is it?
No. McFlys never use aluminum bats. Curious.
Oh, wait, don't touch it. It's evidence.
Of what? Oh, why would anyone do a thing like that to a nice Sector L citizen like me?
What's the last thing you remember?
I was sitting right here, copying another incriminating scene onto my tapes. My tapes? What happened to my tapes?
Stay calm, Dad.
Are they on the floor? Do you see them? They're in a box marked raw footage.
Here it is. Raw footage.
Thank heavens.
Wait a minute.
You see, I told you were just jumping to conclusions. All these dark suspicions about thieves and attackers went all the time. It was just...
empty.
What?
There's no tapes.
But I'm sure they were in there before.
Before whoever it was whacked you in the head and took them.
Oh my gosh, I've been mugged. Mugged in Hill Valley. They can't get away with it. Oh!
Don't worry, Dad. We'll get to the bottom of this.
Who could have done this to me?
Who wouldn't want Doc to get the straight dope on Hill Valley? Edna!
Are you saying I was mugged by the mayor's elderly wife?
Not exactly, no.
Oh, it's no use. The tapes are gone. All I can do is hope against hope they don't surface and land me in trouble.
Come on, Dad, we can't just give up. I mean, maybe there's some more clues around here.
What's the use? Even if we find out who took the tapes, we're not going to be able to get them back without attracting attention to ourselves.
There's got to be something we could do to get our hands on those tapes.
Well, we can make new ones.
We can?
Sure. It may take a while, but if you're willing to help your old man out, it shouldn't take us more than, say, 6 months.
6 months? But I need those tapes now.
You need the tapes.
What I mean is... you know, your time is valuable. I would hate for you to have to redo all that work.
You said you needed the tapes.
I gotta give it to Citizen Brown. I told him I was gonna furnish him with proof that Hill Valley isn't as happy as he thinks it is when I was in his office, just before I came here.
You had an interview with Citizen Brown?
It wasn't easy to get, believe me. I had to break all kinds of rules.
You've been breaking rules?
Harboring stray dogs, kissing girls in public, getting caught with Mom's flask.
That is the most far-fetched story I've ever heard.
It's true.
You forget I'm your father. I know your history.
Yeah, well, history's changed.
Prove it.
Read them and weep.
Demerits, but...
It was the only way.
I don't understand.
Dad, listen to me. I mean, really listen. You and I both know that things aren't right here. Citizen Brown might have started with good intentions, but his Hill Valley's just made everybody miserable.
Shh! You said that to him?
Basically, yeah.
Oh, there go our privileges.
No, wait, I got him to listen, Dad, and he's gonna make things right for you and Mom and all of us. I can't explain how. You're just gonna have to trust me on this.
Okay.
But first I have to show him your tapes, to prove my point.
Oh no, 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 no.
Dad.
This scheme of yours, maybe you know what you're doing, I can't say. But leave me out of
Dad.
It. I don't like trouble. I can't handle it. It's not in my genes.
But... Do it for your father.
My father?
Yeah, Arthur McFly.
I know his name.
Didn't he have something to do with putting away Kid Tan and, you know, way back when?
Yes. Yes, he did. Where do you hear about that? It was way back before Citizen Brown cleaned up the town, before I was even born.
He was there?
Everyone lived in terror of Kid Tannen and his goons. But Dad stood up to him. He had evidence of Kid's guilt, see, and he risked his life to deliver it to the authorities. Never be afraid to do the right thing. That's what he always used to tell me.
And what are you doing?
Trying to remember which is the right feed.
Feed to what?
To the surveillance camera, the one in the yard.
Wait a minute. You have a surveillance camera trained on yourself?
Of course. Gotta cover all bases. Now help me figure out which monitor I'm on.
No problem. I already know.
Hello? Let me get this straight. You captured this whole attack on tape?
Of course! Surveillance is what I do!
Why didn't you say so in the first place?
Come on, son. Stop dawdling and help me track down that feed. Try flipping the switches. There, that looks like us. So the surveillance tape must be on this VCR. This must be before the attack. Let's see. I remember cleaning the playback heads at 5:30. The attack couldn't have been very long after.
Oh, it's Biff!
But it can't be him. The Citizens Plus program has rendered him as gentle as a... kitten.
Huh?
I can't understand it. That's not the way he's supposed to behave. Why, even the old Biff would never...
Hey, wait, what's that weird flashing on his wrist?
Let's find out. I knew this zoom-in enhanced feature would come in handy someday. Cost me a bundle at the hobby shop.
It's his digital watch. I wonder why it's doing that. Hey, wait, stop the picture. Can you zoom in anymore? X11.
You know what that means?
Not yet.
Lorraine!
Don't lay into me, George. I've got something very important to say, and then I'm going to be leaving again.
I've got something important to say, too. I was attacked
it's
and robbed...
It's always about you, isn't it? You can't just wait and listen to my news. Oh, no! You have to go and beat me to the punch.
Pull yourself together.
That's right. You two sort things out. I've got some business to attend to.
I'm more together than I've been in months, George. For your information, I haven't had a drink all day!
settle down there, fella.
You beat up my dad.
Do we have a problem here, citizens?
No, officer. Just a little misunderstanding. I'm sure we can work it out. Right, Martin?
Sure.
Okay. Let me know if you need any help, Mr. Tannen.
Now let's see if we can get to the bottom of this.
Yeah, let's.
Okay, okay. Okay, let's see if we can get to a stopping point here. Hopefully.
Why'd you hurt my dad, Biff? He never did anything to you in this timeline.
Timeline? What are you talking about?
Don't play dumb. I saw you on camera.
But I can't hurt anybody. Thanks to Citizen Plus, I blow chunks whenever I even think about doing bad stuff. See?
If you didn't beat up my dad, then where have you been for the last couple of hours?
Well, I was...
What?
That's strange. I don't remember.
What's the last thing you remember before your memory loss?
Well, I was handing out flyers for the Citizen Plus program, just like I'd been doing all day. I just finished giving some leftover bologna to a cute little squirrel when Miss Edna came by.
Edna?
You gave bologna to a squirrel?
Yeah, she wanted to run a diagnostic on my Citizen Plus watch. I must have fallen asleep or something, because when she was done, it was an hour later. And then your mom came by.
Biff, your watch. Does X-11 mean anything to you?
X-11? Is that a new band or something? I don't go in for that new hippity-hoppity stuff.
It's not a band, Biff. It's a mode on your Citizen Plus watch.
Weird. I've never seen it look like that. Heck, I can barely get this thing to stop blinking. See? I didn't know you could do that.
Okay, I'm gonna see if we can save. There. So yeah, gonna leave it here for now. Think have enough for another good length video, but gonna see about next time. See about fixing Biff's watch, and finding the tape, and showing it to Doc and everything, and just generally finishing up this episode. So, for now, adios, auf Wiedersehen, aloha, all that good stuff, and until next time, remember to keep at least one of your surveillance cameras trained on your works, on your monitors. That just went all backwards. See ya.